Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It's my pleasure to be here with you today. I would like to explore a fundamental question with you. Are the challenges of the police in 2018 similar to those it faced only 10 years ago? I would say that the answer to this question is resounding no. This is not an Israeli answer to the question, but the answer that arises from every one of my meetings with my colleagues all over the world, in general, and in the Western world in particular. But it appears that not all of them agree on the Archimedean point, which is, what is the main generator that has exposed us to such profound changes? I shall attempt, in the brief time at my disposal, to present an inclusive perception of our insight as well as the barriers we are dealing with in order to provide service and security as a national police force. I presume that I shall not surprise you if I present the connectivity of the world as a significant generator of the changes. However, I may surprise you with the claim that it is the sole generator of all the changes. Its effect is so dramatic that if we forget to relate to it in every issue we are dealing with, we are probably not creating a correct response. During the last two decades, the world has become connected and flat. The necessity was economic, and it came from the desire for increased prosperity. The enabler was naturally technological. Thus, the economic rate is no longer the ship's sailing speed, but the speed of transferring the information by the optics fiber. This is a rate of purchase and sale which creates an absolutely connected and flat economic world. A world where nobody knows how to say anymore just how much sanctions against Iran will adversely affect his own investments. In conversation on the matter with colleagues, the matter of terrorism immediately crops up. The countries supporting terrorism, the challenges of espionage in the age of the internet, naturally, the cyber attacks and the strategic effects enabled by the web and more. There's no doubt that in all these dimensions, there has indeed been a dramatic change, which transfers the first to the rear, creates a pattern of lone wolf terrorism and more. Certainly, these things are true for the Israeli police, which by law is entrusted with internal security. These changes will which all originate in the connectivity of the world, generate dramatic changes in the challenges facing the Israeli police in the matter of security. On the other hand, from my conversation with colleagues, I have learned that the revolution in the field of crime, both the threats and the opportunities, as well as the social change which influenced the work of the police, is not really on the table. As I understand it, the change has become about in this field is no less dramatic than the security one. And in the internet age of blurred boundaries between terrorism and crime, they are also empowering each other. Whoever has been following the crime figures during the last decade, with an emphasis on property crime, can identify a consistent decline in the scope of reported crime. True, in the digital age, the police has no opportunities in the field of collecting evidence, opportunities which make things more difficult for criminals. Our property is more protected and less sellable, but this can't explain the entire depth of the change. It seems that there is no alternative but to admit that part of the phenomena is connected to the shift of crime to the cyber world. It is not complicated to understand that the phenomena that we are seeing in the field of security is very similar to that in the world of crime. Just as countries prefer using advanced methods via the web, including the use of proxies, to fight their enemies without moving their forces and without paying an international political price, so do the criminals. There's no need to take a risk by robbing a bank if it is possible to easily steal the same sum online. There's no need to manage illegal casinos that are subject to police raids If it is possible to gamble online, if it is possible to rape a woman online without getting up from one's chair, and to commit serious pedophilic offenses without leaving one's house. I hope that it is not necessary to explain that the mental damage to minor from these offenses is liable to be no less severe than from the traditional form of the offense. In view of these developments, the police is confronted with enormous challenges. Firstly, as in the traditional offenses, the police needs to gather intelligence. When we are dealing with the internet, the standard form of collection is monitoring the web, or actually extensive collection and the identification of anomalies. On the internet, such monitoring is immediately perceived as an invasion of privacy. What is perceived as legitimate for the purpose of thwarting terrorism is perceived as disproportionate for the purpose of fighting crime. Insofar as the police restricts itself to collecting targeted intelligence only for the purpose of conducting an investigation and only up to a court order, it is clear that it will not succeed in providing sufficient response against the scope of this phenomenon. We must remember that the police challenge is not only in collecting evidence of which computer or smartphone committed the offense. We must prove beyond any reasonable doubt the identity of the offender who sat at the keyboard while committing the offense or held the smartphone. This is a new world of evidence. Part of the challenge is to accustom the courts to deal with this new kind of evidence and also to convince the court of the weight of the evidence. Today, such cases before the court have the potential to shape the case law in this area and will determine in the future the chances we have to reduce the threats in these cases. Needless to say, these internet offenses expose the citizen of the state to a criminal threat from all over the world, and vice versa, opposite endless options for Israeli offenders. Thus, for example, an Israeli is able to find himself exposed to ransomware from all corners of the globe, and not only for Israeli criminals. The Israeli citizen expects protection from the Israeli police, and rightly so, not only from threats by another Israeli citizen in our own country. Israeli offenders who wish to be far from the eyes of the Israeli police prefer to reside abroad, to use the anonymity enabled by the internet, and to advance encrypting tools in order to carry out serious crime all over Israel, like, for example, passing on instructions for the murder of rivals or witnesses who are planning to incriminate them in court. In the age of the internet, there are more and more virtual assets which are less subject to seizure and forfeiture of the enforcement agencies in Israel. The ability to use virtual currencies, the ability to use virtual proxies, all this makes the offenders less vulnerable and require the police to develop not only new technological tools, but to expand its circle of partnerships in order to increase its effectiveness. Firstly, effective partnerships between the police and all the other enforcement agencies are required. The Israel Tax Authority, the IMPA, the Israel Money Laundering Terror Financing Prohibition Authority, the Capital Market Commissioner, and others, alongside the traditional partners such as the State Attorney Office and Israel Security Agency. Only a fusion of all the information between the authorities allow us to reduce the loopholes, get our hands on the, the interests of the criminal organizations. Secondly, the Israel police is required to significantly expand the scope of its activity worldwide, to add police representatives, and to expand its cooperation with Interpol, Europol, and other bilateral partners. During the last year, we expanded our activity in China, in Europe, and in America. We added an additional representative at the General Secretariat of Interpol. A police officer from Israel was appointed to be the commander of the Cyber Fusion Center at Interpol Singapore. Furthermore, we signed a memorandum of understanding with Europol, which includes placing of an Israeli police representative at their headquarters. When the rest of the enforcement agencies, headed by the IMPA, maintain close working relationships with fellow agencies all over the world, then the online loopholes are reduced, and many times it is possible to turn a threat into an opportunity. There are those who say, and rightly so, that with regard to the threats against Israelis, the unique Hebrew language still supplies us with an envelope of protection. The present algorithms cope better with translation Hebrew to English than vice versa, something that still allows us to locate suspects who are attempting to operate in written Hebrew when they do not speak the language. But we are not invincible. Mathematics will soon bridge the gap, and we shall grapple with the same threats as countries with Latin languages. On the other hand, Israel is a country of Jewish immigrants from all corners of the globe who speak most of the languages in the world. More than a few criminals exploit these skills in order to commit crimes in other countries, using their language skills for sophisticated fraud purposes and more. Naturally, Israel is responsible for the activity of the Israeli offenders all over the world, which creates daily interfaces with our colleagues worldwide in order to provide a professional response regardless of the offender's location on the globe. It appears that a substantial change has also occurred in the traditional offenses, which creates a great opportunity. From the moment we entered the age of big data and began to analyze crime phenomena with completely new tools, we discovered that the way we had been dealing with criminal gangs was not always correct. Thus, for example, when we at Israel Police analyzed all the property offenders via big data, we found that this was a web picture and not a hierarchical one. We found then is alternative economy, where there is a demand side and a supply side inside it. Thousands of offenders who act independently, who make decisions according to supply and demand, exactly like in the legitimate world. This means that by a simple analysis, it is possible to build a plan on how to weaken the effectiveness of the web of crime phenomena with minimal actions and arrests. There are hubs on web of crime which when removed, isolate many connections on the net and significantly weaken it. It is both possible and mandatory to analyze every phenomenon of crime in this way, and the potential effectiveness of the police increases a thousandfold. In Israel, we become accustomed to a consistent decline in property crime by about 3% a year. But with a new method of analysis, the rate of decline this year reached 15%. During the past decade, we have reduced by 3 to 4% the car theft each year. But we ended last year with a drop of almost 20%, and this year the rate of decline is about another 18% on top. This year, we are at the rate of decline of about 20% in apartment break-ins. These are the achievements that we could not have imagined in the past, and we have the potential to do even better. The condition for success is the assumption of networks. The entire world is on the web, so that we must release ourselves of linear, at least with regard to the macro analysis of the crime. It is very important to break away from linear thought in the organization and to act in networking way also inside the organizations, despite the internal hierarchy within the organization. This is so that we will not be dependent upon the weakened link of the change and create actions that empower each other. By the way, we should note that the fact that the Israel Police is a national police force, where every policeman in Israel is subject to one chain of command, makes the implementation of these ideas possible. In one national police force, there is one IT department Everyone creates and uses the same data as if working on one desktop. This enabled us to quickly apply reforms and facilitate mutual learning and professional research at record speeds. When a police force is required to form effective integration with different internal police forces, which have incompatible computer systems and different procedures and perceptions, naturally the gap between the abilities of the offenders to take advantage of technology and the ability of the police to apprehend them is widened. Also in this area, the Israel police has a built-in advantage. And the final offenses that we often tend to disregard are those that the normative citizens commit against each other. For example, noise complaint, blocking streets or parking spaces, and trespassing. These constitute about 50% of the offenses reported to the police. I'm always surprised at how much these matters are not being dealt with within the world through the prism of the networks. During the past decade, there has been a dramatic increase in the number of these kind of offenses which are reported to the police. Through thorough analysis, we have found that massive urbanization and a sharp increase in the value of privacy and in the way in which we build residential towers creates a very isolated living environment for people. Indeed, man is a political creature, as Aristotle taught us, and he requires society and a community. But in the age of the internet, man often finds compensation for community in the social networks. Whether it's a professional community or any other kind, whether it is a community of people he knows or anonymous beings, the community on the internet does not represent the people who live in the person's neighborhood. These people become strangers and estranged because nobody knows his neighbor. The lack of acquaintance creates new social phenomena. One, a decline in the level of regard for the neighborhood. A person's behavior is generally situational and is influenced by the question of who is in his vicinity. People tend to be more considerate of people they know than of strangers. Therefore, the number of offenses increases. At the same time, a second phenomenon of a stranger develops. The stranger is always alien and frightening. It is better not to deal with him and turn immediately to the police. Thus, a noise complaint from the neighbor's apartment becomes a police matter, and this kind of offense increases among reported offenses. This insight has led us to increase our efforts in returning the feeling of mutual commitment in society by various and varied methods. The vast majority of them are by means of partnerships with authorities, including by means of returning the community to the citizens. We have realized that a citizen without a community is a less patient citizen who is less considerate and more violent. This creates an entirely new way of looking at community policing. The Israel Police has developed new and creative methods, one of which is a police youth group in coordination with the Ministry of Education, whose purpose is the use of youth in order to reinforce the norm of obedience to the law. We have learned that it is possible to empower youth to build within themselves an internal policeman in order to restore mutual commitment to the youth that have grown up in the age of the internet. It is possible to empower youth in situations where they is capable of mentally stopping internet shaming of another youth before it becomes too late. It also follows that these young people affect not only their peers, but also the adults, the parents, the teachers, and the counselors around them. This approach also formed the basis for the establishment of a combined hotline of the police together with various government ministries in order to deal with offenses against youth on the internet. This hotline allows a choice as to which is the correct party for handling each problem. When it is a matter of shaming between the youth, it's better that the police not take the lead. But if the shaming is done by a teacher, that is a different situation. I have attempted to demonstrate in these few minutes just how much the change in the task of the police varies from one extreme to the other in this age, not only in the field of terrorism and external security, but also in the area of internal security in the most profound sense of the word. The strength of country's society is a critical element of its national security, in its national security. A police force that wishes to be effective for the citizens is compelled to recognize the uses of the internet, to think big, and to provide complex and innovative responses to the threats which have been created. I'm proud that the Israel police, despite the rare becoming the front, despite the increasing security burden passed to us from the shoulders of the IDF, despite its being a police force of first responders, certainly against lone wolf terrorism, but also in case of natural disaster and more, succeeds in being a pioneer in dealing with a serious crime, as well as with more minor offenses of normative citizens, which has come from our profound understanding of the changes being generated in today's world. Thank you all for your attention.